Hi everyone, I'm Ankit, Applications Engineer at Wolfram. Today I will be giving you an overview of system modeling functionality in Mathematica. I will be accompanied by Malte, the lead developer of this functionalities. He will be helping me in replying to all your questions. In this talk, I will be going through this system modeling page, which gives you a brief but complete picture of all the functionalities. You can find the link to this page in the comment section. So system modeling. System models have been used in various fields to understand and optimize complex systems. For example, let's say you want to design a controller to control the speed of a DC motor, or you want to control the concentration of products in a mixing tank. Tuning a controller using a hardware may be too risky or very expensive and time consuming. You need a good starting point to implement your controller, which will shorten your design cycle. In such cases, you can use a system model to do your initial tuning of your controllers. There are several such examples in other fields where engineers have been using system models to analyze complex systems. So the natural question occurs, like, how does Mathematica support system modeling? Well, we provide over 500 plus pre-built example models, which can serve as templates for your models. There are over 7,000 plus components, which you can just connect and build a system, just like a Lego model. Or you can define your own custom components from equations or data. You can also create components using drag and drop using the graphical user interface of System Modeler and directly use it in Mathematica. Moreover, you can also compare scenarios using parametric sweeps and plot any of the possible model variables. You can perform various design and analysis, such as linearizing a nonlinear model around an operating point, or perform calibration and optimization. And the list goes on. Today, I will be focusing on three different examples, which will showcase how you can do model, how you can design, and how you can do analysis. Let's begin with the first model, where we create a model programmatically. Let me open my Mathematica notebook here. Great. So in this example, we are going to model a cam and follower mechanism, and we are going to test three different cams here. So before we begin, let's first define the equations of the three cam profiles. So we do that here. Great. Now, once you have the cam profile equations defined, you can cross-check by doing a plot of it. Now you have the contour of the three cams ready, but this contours lack equation. Now let's define some equations for these contours. Here. So as you can see in this equations, I'm using some certain variables like flange r.phi or flange t.s. These variables belong to a built-in component, which I will be using subsequently in this model. And what this equation does is it converts the rotational motion of the cam into translational motion for the follower. So now once we have defined the equations, let's start creating the model. In order to create this model, I'm using a partial class or helper class, which extends the rotational motion to translational motion. This is a pre-built component built into Mathematica. And I'm initializing this model for an initial angle of 0 degrees. So let's create this model. So here, the create system model helps you to create a system model from this equations and the cam profile. This function takes the name of the model as the first argument. And the second argument, you have the equations defining the model. In the third argument, you have the independent variable. For us, it is t in this case. and spec, where we are extending a partial class. So now we have created three different system models, but this system models are stationary. In order to rotate this model, we will be needing a rotational source. Also, we have not defined the follower yet. In this model, we'll be defining the follower as a spring, and we will be attaching the spring to a fixed frame. So let's define this components. For this components, I'm using the pre-built components built in Mathematica, so which are like the constant speed source, the spring element, and fixed frame element. So let's define the components. Now, once the components are defined, we need to state how these components are interrelated to each other, like how the components are connected. So for that, we'll be using connections. So here we define all the connections, like how the components are connected. Now we use the new system functionality, which is the connect system model components. And what this function does is it takes the name of the system model, and then it takes all the components in the system model and takes the connections. And based on that, it creates new system models. So let's do that. So this will create three independent systems, Let's visualize like what each system contains. So as we discussed before, this is the CAM system which we just created, and this is the constant speed source for this CAM, and the spring represents the follower, and the spring is attached to a fixed frame as reference. So now we have all the three components. Now let's go ahead and simulate this models. So in order to simulate this models, we have a function called system model simulate, which takes the name of the model as the first argument. And the second argument, you define the duration. If your simulation time starts from 0, you can just define 5. But if you're interested in a time interval, then you can define the time interval as list in this as a second argument. And in the third argument, you can define certain parameter values for the model. So here you can see now we got three different plots for the three different CAM profiles. So depending on use case you have or what type of mechanism you want to implement, from this graph you can make a design decision. Similarly, you can also do further analysis on this. For instance, you can calculate jerk, which is nothing but the derivative of acceleration. And this will give you a measure of the stress and wear on the CAM. But you are also free to do any type of analysis using this system models. Great, okay. So we are done with the first example, and we saw certain system model functionalities, such as system model plot, which takes the simulation data from the system model simulate and plots it. Then we have system model simulate function. We saw connect system model components function, and then we saw our create system model function. Now let's move on to the next example, where we will be designing a controller. A control system is one of the important use case of system modeling. And in this case, we will be designing a control system which will keep a segue in its vertical position. So let's start by linearizing this model. So in this case, we are using a pre-built model called Lego Segway Base. And what the system model linearize function is doing is it's taking the model around this operating point. And for us, the operating point is the initial value, which is the vertical position in this case. And it takes an argument called method, where we have defined it as numeric derivative. You can use numeric derivative if all the parameters in the models are defined. But if you want to use, if you are uncertain about certain parameters, such as if you're uncertain about the length of the segue, you can keep it in symbolic form, and then you can give a method as symbolic derivative. So the system model linearized function takes both numeric derivative and symbolic derivative as the method. And once we get the state space model from the system model linearized function, we can extract the key parameters or the key states. Like, it will give us a lot of states, but all the states are not equally important. So we will extract the key states from the system model linearized output. So here we have the state space model, which we just obtained. And for this case, we are going to design a LQ regulator. And for LQ regulator, let's define the QR matrices. As you can see, we are having a huge value of 50,000. And this 50,000 is meant as a penalty for the state revolute 1.phi. This means that any deviation in phi is highly penalized in the control system. So now once we have defined the states, once we have the state space model, we have defined the Q and R, we can go ahead and use the LQ regulator gains to obtain the gain values. Now, the next step would be, now we have are using another model called LQ control model, and this has the LQ, this has the LQ controller connected to the base model which we just linearized. So now we let's redefine this model. Yes. So now let's redefine this model with the new parameter values for the regulator gains which we obtained in the previous step. Now let's do that. And once you have done this, you can check the output as an animation in system modeler. But in this case, because of lack of time, I'm just using the animation which we have pre-made for you. As you can see, the segue is in vertical position now, and we are applying some momentary horizontal force to it. But still, the segue is able to maintain its vertical position. Okay. So in this example, you saw the new function, the system model linearized function, and then you saw the two different methods you can linearize a model, like the numeric derivative, and the other, which I didn't show you, is the symbolic derivative. Now let's move ahead to our last example, which is the connect data to models example. Let's open that. So in this example, what we want to obtain is, we are using a predefined house sitting model, and we are giving it external, we're giving its external temperature data, and we want to analyze the house heating for different controller set points. So let's begin this example by getting the temperature data for a given location. Let's get the temperature data for Champagne and for the year 23rd January. So we are using the weather data functionality of Mathematica to obtain the temperature and time, the temporal data of temperature. Now, once we have the temporal data, we can convert those data into seconds for better processing later on. So let's convert this. Now you can see the temperature starts from zero and extends till 80,000 seconds. It's around 20 hours, I guess. So, and you can see for this particular day, the temperature varies from minus 14 degree centigrade to around minus 2 degrees centigrade. Now let's use a pre-built model. for house heating. So this house heating model is predefined, is a pre-built model in Mathematica. We're using it, and then we are redefining it with a new set of parameter values. And this parameter values is the new temperature curve which we obtained in the previous case. So let's recreate a new system model with new outside temperature values. Once we have that, let's simulate and plot the house temperature. So as you can see, the orange curve here shows the outside temperature. The green curve on the top shows the reference temperature, which is defined by us. And the green and the sorry, and the blue curve shows the average temperature inside the room. And this is being adjusted by the control system, which we have implemented in this model. Now, to begin our further analysis on cost and energy consumption, let's first obtain the cost of electricity for this particular place on the same day. So let's use Wolfram Alpha to get the cost. And once we have the cost, now we can define our own custom functions. For in this case, I've used an energy used function where I am getting the radiator power from the simulation, like I'm obtaining the data from the simulation and using it in my custom function. So let's define this function. And once this function is defined, let's define a, yes. So once this function is defined, let's define a range of indoor temperature. Like these are the indoor set points which we'll be using for comparison. So we are defining from a range of 19 to 24. And then we are defining two different scenarios. In the first scenario, the control system is on throughout the day. And in the second scenario, the control system is on only for a particular duration of time during a day. So let's define this models. As you can see here, we are using the same model, but setting the parameter values to something else. We are using the same model, but you're creating two different instances. So this shows the modularity of system modeling. So now we go ahead and do the energy, the expenses, the cost calculations for the scenarios which we just defined. Let's go ahead and do that. Yes. Yeah. So now you can see that for different preset condition or different reference temperature, we have different energy expenses. And for the two different scenarios, we have two different energy expenses. Similarly, you can obtain any data from the house heating model and do your own custom analysis. So these three examples gave you an overview of how you can model, design, and analyze using the system modeling functionality. But you're not only limited to that. We also have examples on calibration or deploying your code to hardware. And you can also do some advanced analysis like studying system reliability or do some sensitivity analysis. You can follow this in our system modeling marketing page over here. And in today's presentation, I discussed some of these functions, but I have not been able to discuss all the functions. If you want to know more about these functions, you can go to the respective pages. Or if you want to have a proper tutorial about these functions, you can go to the respective overview pages. So I think that's all from my presentation today. So Malte, do you want to add anything which I'm missing, or do you think it's all right?
I think we can say that great presentation, by the way. This was about the system modeling functionality in Mathematica. Was the focus for this presentation. There is also a complete different product, which we didn't mention that much, which is System Modeler, Wolfram System Modeler, which is a graphical interface for creating models in a more interactive drag and drop way. And it also comes with a simulation environment to interactively simulate and plot variables from your simulation. So if you want to do more advanced hierarchical graphical drag and drop modeling, you should also check out the Wolfram System Modeler product, which is a great complement to all the features we saw in the presentation.
Yep.
And if you have both Mathematica and Wolfram System Modeler, they do interact with each other. So when you're creating something in System Modeler, it's immediately available in Mathematica to simulate and analyze further.
Great. And if you are interested in any particular domain, then you can go to the find examples page. Here, all the domains are listed, and you can go to any particular domain and you can find suitable examples. So this will help you kickstart your project in a very convenient manner. Yep. So I think that's all from our side. Thank you.